What's going on? So, got a weekend off of school. I wanted to do this project as soon as I could because it's something I've been looking forward to for a while. And yeah, it's just kind of like me. You all know how like any vehicle comes with those stock crappy speakers. Maybe if you have like a good like Sony system or Bose, but even then, there's some pretty good aftermarket products that are a lot better than that. So what I got here are some Rockford Fosgate. So I got some 6.5s for the back and I got 6x9s for the front. And then I don't know if you guys have seen this before, but these are like these enhancement little foam rings. You basically put around the speaker. So for example, this 6x9, you'd put it around it. So it pushes all like the fullness of the sound towards you. And there's also this little like mat that you put on the inside of your door that also keeps the bass from just rattling around inside your door, and it kind of, you know, pushes everything back. So yeah, so we're gonna go ahead and install these. So I'm gonna show you how to take off the door panels and how to do this and strip the wire and all that good stuff. So stick around. Already on, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you what I'm just gonna be using today. This is what I've been told to use. All right, so I'm gonna have my removal kit here so I get all these trim pieces off pretty easy without breaking anything. You're gonna need a 7mm right here to get up in there and get some of those screws out. Gonna have it use a wire stripper, so I went and picked this up today, and also got some of these little pliers, some needle nose, and all kinds of different varieties of some of that, and some electrical tape. I don't have a soldering kit, so I guess this is just a different way that I'm gonna be doing this. These speakers right here aren't your typical plug and play type, and you probably could say I can go get adapters, but I mean, this was kind of like the, I don't know, just a different way to do it, maybe a cheaper way, I don't know. So I don't have a problem with this. It's just a learning experience. We go ahead and show you how to get these door panels off. So I'll do the fronts and the backs, and then I won't bore you with the rest. I'll just show you one of each.
All right, so we're removing the door panel for either the driver or the passenger side. There's this little panel right here with this little tab you can take out. There's also one down here with this little tab. So it's gonna reveal 2 7mm. This one's gonna have one. You're gonna take this piece off here. It's gonna reveal some more. I'll show you that later. And then there's 2 more 7mm down here. And this piece right here will come off. There's like little tabs that hold on to this one.
There's these little tabs, and sometimes they'll come off, but fortunately these didn't.
And there's the 7mm bolt way back there. And they say like, they recommend getting a magnet, but I don't have one of those. So if you're in my shoes, then we'll figure out how to get that out.
It kind of makes me nervous because like all of these are coming out super, super simple. Like they were just barely put on, so hopefully I'll fix any issues that might come from there. Look at that, I didn't barely have to turn it. I mean, I understand like not over torquing, but that was like super easy. So basically I was using the smaller kind of ratchet, so now I had to bring out the big guy so that I could reach in there, because otherwise I wouldn't reach, because it is pretty far back. Oh, now I see why it says to get a magnet. Yeah, so I don't have a magnet, which would be awesome. So if you do, don't worry. But if you don't, I just use the same tool I did to pry the little trim pieces out. And I'm just kind of digging them out here. Ooh. Got it. So supposedly now the whole door is supposed to be able to just like kind of pop like out and up. Once you get over this lock right here. They said to grab right here and pull these tabs out. There we go. There we go. Try not to break anything, but it's being pretty complicated here. I think I got the bottom ones too. Yeah, so now this whole bottom is loose. I'm gonna go from the inside over here. Okay, whenever you're getting ready to pull a whole door panel off, you're gonna wanna grab this side over here and this side by the lock. There we go. There we go. You wanna push your lock in
tag back into its position.
But you're going to press this little tab down right here. Yep, so now you're going to pull this tab back and come around, take out this little ball right here.
All
right,
guys, so what you're going to do is
there's this little red tab down here. That one, you push it back. This is black tab, you push it down, and this will come out.
Yeah, I'll have to put the camera down, but basically, like, yeah, this will pull right back out.
All right, then whenever you get that off, you're going to get your weather strip here, and you're going to pull, I like to pull mine out just towards the back of the door, so you just take it, pull it out, and then you're going to get, you're going to have these little tabs in here. Come in closer. These four, or I'm sorry, but these silver ones right here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this little clip, and back here in the back, you want to push that down and pull out. Now we're going to take these clips and put them back into these little holes right here they belong into.
Put it like that.
It's right back on. So you just do that for all of them, and then you'll be good to go. Then you get your weather strip and just slide it right back on there. Now this right here is our main focus for today. So here we are with the old OEM stock speakers. They're not bad, but they're stock, not even Bose. So
it's 1 7mm up here. We're gonna go ahead and take off.
All right, now that we've gotten that 7mm out, you just take this and you just push up on it. There we go. Go ahead and disconnect this wire. Oh yeah, there's a little button over here. Just push that. Just take that right off. Here we go. Look at that tiny little magnet. We're gonna go ahead and unbox the 6x9s really quick. Now we got a bigger magnet. And some of you might be familiar with Rockford and say that the primes are pretty garbage. I mean, honestly, anything's better than stock. And I was trying to have like a budget-friendly type upgrade, so we're gonna try this out. Not too bad. All right, y'all. So we're at this point where this is the point of no return. So what I've done so far is I took this little piece of plastic here, and this is whenever you rip out this speaker. And in order to get the other one to fit in here, you're gonna wanna have to rip all this out. So kind of show you a little bit here, and then I'll do the rest off camera. So basically just take the old speaker and just pull it up like that. Look at that, just paper. That's what you're listening on the whole time, is just paper and this tiny little magnet. So now, do you see all these like little pieces in here that are all these braces that are holding this in? You want to break those out. So I know I don't have like the biggest pair of little needle nose pliers, but I'm gonna try to get these and break these out so we can make room for that other guy. See, now we just go all the way around, do the same thing. So I'll catch up with you whenever I clear this out more. All right, y'all, so I just finished and this knob just fell out. So don't need that anymore. But do you see how there's still like this kind of clutter in here? And possibly this big ring too, I'm gonna have to get out. I'm pretty sure I do. So yeah, but for now, we're gonna go ahead and, yeah, we're just gonna go ahead and clear this big ring off. And then we'll make any other adjustments come later. And I wanna try to keep this right here. I think this is exactly where the speaker's gonna fit in here. And the whole point of this is to keep the stock housing, so you don't have to go buy like an adapter and spend an extra like 20 something dollars. And you know, it takes you maybe 10 minutes. All right, guys, fast forward some. And so basically, I finally got the speaker in there. Tore everything out to the edge. I actually advise to leave just a little bit in there because you can tell there's a gap. And then I got this foam stuff I was talking about earlier, and I put it on the side that'll hopefully push some of the sound out and keep the sub in there, or the speaker. So now we're going to come in here and get inside there and go ahead and splice some wires and hopefully see if it works. All right, guys. All right, so now we're at the point where I'm gonna go ahead and cut this. So I'll show you on every speaker, but basically
Every wire that has this black line in it is your ground, and then here's your power. So when I go to connect these two speakers, or connect these two wires, make sure I put my black on this side and my red on this side.
So cut that piece off. Go ahead and strip these down. That's 14.
16. Alrighty guys, honestly, it is probably like 2.5 to 3 hours later of me just trying to figure out how to like strip down wires, because I've never done this before, and just getting. So basically, remember how I told you I took all this out? Well, yeah, there it is basically. So it took me a lot to do that, and also to get this to stay in there, I screwed it down on two sides to kind of keep it pressured in there. Remember, I put these little foam rings around it, and I also went in here and I cut around from where the window would be. So that's in there perfectly. It's stuck in there. So I've already tested it, and it pushes all the bass back into the cab. It's amazing. So this way the bass isn't rattling around in your door. But yeah, I was really nervous to cut this off and, you know, do this, because I mean, this is the point of no return. So basically I put the wires, I stripped both of them, twisted them together, electrical taped them, and then electrical taped the entire set here. And this is, oh my gosh, I'm so, oh yeah, let me show you the back. And then you just clamp those on there. So the white with the black wire with the white strip is your power. And then of course your ground is your black one. But this is what I'm excited about. Check this out. It works. Took a while, but it works. But yeah, so we're gonna go ahead and put the speaker back on. Or back in its place, and basically just put the whole door together, and then we got three more to go, and I'm kind of killing daylight, so. But at least I know what to do now. I'm more comfortable with stripping the wires. I know to take the doors off now, so hopefully the other three shouldn't be as bad. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and get the back door off here for the passenger side. So this one's pretty simple, actually. You don't need to take this piece off. There's just the same two in here, one in here, and then there's one down here. And then the same thing, it'll pop off. Oh, caught it. Basically, take some pry tools, get it back here, so you know I'm popping out. Now we just pop the rest off this side. This was just pretty easy. You just kind of lift up on it. Oh, that was a freaking hassle. Now we just come down here, get this little sucker up. There we go. I think it's the same procedure.
Yep.
Pull it out. Oh my goodness. That sucker does not want to come out. Anyway, we're going to just, here's a little tab right here. One is on this harness. God dog, boy. Thing is in there. Holy crap. God. That little itty, god dog, son. Yep, so basically it's gonna be the same procedure with this guy. Look at this, it's just literal paper. I can crumble it up. Yeah, we're just gonna take this, we're gonna flip it over here. Actually, we're gonna rip all of this out first. And then when we get that out, we'll come back here, clean it up. We'll get all these little connectors out. All this will come out, and then all we gotta do is just put the other speaker in there. Got some screws to mount it up with, and then pop it in there.
we're good to go.
Like I said, first thing we gotta do is just take this right here and basically we're just gonna do this. We're gonna just get up in here and just get to the point of no return. See, now we'll go back here, get all this cleaned out, so I'll catch up with you then.
Alright guys, so I just finished ripping everything out from the original housing and I just put the new speaker in, and I'm going to show you how I did it, how like I engineered it to fit in there. Not really, but this is what I did.
So basically, so here it is now. So what I did is, of course, I tore out the internal components and some of the clips, but as you can see, I left a lot of this in here. And I just trimmed it really good so I can make sure these connectors, these will fit right back on. And here's my argument. So I kept this in here, and as you can see, the reason when that happens, this gap is gonna stay here. Well, like I said, roast me in the comments or whatever, but my argument is that these screws, with my other one, I had an issue getting it in there. These screws right here, the only thing holding it in here right now. And with this, I don't know if you can really see in there, there's a screw. This is the only thing holding it down. See, ain't going nowhere at all. So I feel like that gap isn't gonna be life or death type deal. So we'll see what happens. I'm gonna go try to connect it up, and I'll let you know if anything changes, but this is what I'm doing so far. So I'm gonna go ahead and splice the wires and we'll get them hooked up.
All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this harness right here, and basically I want to peel back this tape going on.
Now that I got these clear, I'm gonna go ahead and take this, strip these down, and then we'll put them together, put some electrical tape on, and test out the speaker. All right, so now all I did was I stripped them down and I just rolled them around each other. Like I said, the blue black is your negative, your white over here is your positive. See, I just rolled them around. So now I'm gonna get my electrical tape, tape each separately by itself, and then I'm gonna tape them together, and we'll hook them up to the speaker and see if it worked. All right, so now we got them all taped off pretty good. Like I said, I'm gonna tape these together, but I just wanted to show you this piece. It's like I said, your red wire is going over here. There's your positive, and they're different sizes too, so it's pretty easy to connect them. And you got your black to ground, so now the speaker should be able to work. So let's go ahead and finish taping that up, and then we'll test, see if it works. Down to the flow, I'm done with the flesh. I let the spirit take control. Standing in the way, though this ain't a show, you won't run away. Be right here. All right, so now you see it works. All I did is just like, it's plugged in there. Went ahead and fix that up. I know, roast me in the comments, it's really tacky, but hey, it works. So, but yeah, so now we're gonna go put it back in there and just put the door back together. And so if you're curious about that, I'll show you, but it's basically just the same thing as the front. There's this little connector here. You got this, the one that goes in the door, and then you just push that up through the top and then you're good to go. But yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and get this all back in there. All
right, y'all. So just finished getting the passenger side all done, so the back and the front. And like I said, now we're gonna go ahead and do the driver's side now that I know what to do. So hopefully this can go decently quick while still making good progress. But yeah, it's like 8 o'clock right now. I started at like 1, so a little longer than I thought it was gonna be, but hey, we're learning here. Never done it, a little nervous, so I'm kind of going slow, but I'm gonna go ahead and skip to that when I finish these. We can not build it, tell us to be. Never let down, we back on our feet. Welcome to the other side. I live my life like it's my only night. People just wanna be free. I'm the only one who carry the key. We can not build it, tell us to be. Never let down, we back on our feet. Welcome to the other side. I live my life like All right, y'all. So I finished up around like 10:30 last night. It was freezing cold.
I was tired. I worked on this all these speakers from about like 1 to like I said 10:30. So I was dead tired. So we're gonna go ahead and get the after results now. And I'll be honest with you, I'm a little disappointed. I know they weren't anything too special, too bumpy and flashy and expensive, which I was trying to stay budget friendly, but it seems as like stock is kind of outdoing it right now, at least for the bass, because that's like my favorite thing. I understand there's a break-in period, but I'm gonna get your opinion on this. I'm gonna go ahead and put the two clips together, but let's go ahead and do that now so you can hear the comparison between stock and the Rockford Fosgate. All right, guys, so that's it right there. For one, I just hope you guys enjoyed this video about this comparison. So even if I take a loss, you can learn something here, so you don't have to go spend about $160 on this stuff. But yeah, you know, it's not bad. I understand that there is a break-in period. I get that part. So we're going to try to work around that. The guy said if I don't like them within 30 days, I'll take them back and replace them. So I might do that, but we'll see. I'm going to give it a shot. I'm not just going to jump the gun and say they are terrible and all this other stuff. So I'm going to wait a little bit and just see if they kind of wear in, if the bass gets a little better, whatever. But yeah, so hopefully you guys learned something from this video. I hope you do like it. My biggest takeaway and victory is that the speakers work. You know, from digging out and gutting out those housings and making those fit in there and cutting the wires, which was the scariest part for me, and then, you know, splicing them and then, you know, wrapping them up and all that good stuff. So I'm glad it works. That's my biggest victory from today. But like I said, I do this for you guys. You know, I want you to learn from this stuff and from my mistakes. And then, so like I said, if you were looking at these and you're like, well, this guy said they suck, you know, like I said, I get it. We'll play with it a little bit. We'll see if I can like it, and I'll update on you maybe like a month or so. So when a month rolls around and I still don't like them, we'll get these out of here and then you'll know. So like I said, hope you guys enjoy the video. You know, as always, like, subscribe, do whatever you want to do, your choice. And I'll see you in the next video.